It doesn't smell like a pine tree. It doesn't taste like a pine tree. Well, a little bit. And it isn't a pine tree. And it certainly isn't growing in places where I would expect to find pine trees. I'm here on the coast of northeastern Kenya, right on the beach. Temperatures right now around 33 degrees Celsius and picking up. It's about 8 o'clock in the morning, so plenty of time to go. And one thing I really wouldn't expect to find in this place is a pine tree-like tree. But, and I imagine that many of you, people who've been to the coast in, for example, Australia, South Africa, Kenya, here where I am, maybe Brazil, Argentina, possibly in Florida, have seen trees just like this and wondered, what on earth is this pine-like looking tree doing right here on the beach? Well, I, Gus, the African plant hunter, will now reveal the hidden secret behind this tree. This is Casuarina equisetum, and it is indeed not a conifer, not a pine tree. It's an evergreen. It's a native to Australasia, Southeast Asia, and it's spread all over the world, particularly found in coastal areas. Why? Because it is incredibly resilient to saline soils, and it's deliberately grown by people in coastal areas to stabilize soils. It's also nitrogen fixing, in fact, which makes it doubly useful. But it is, of course, not, as I said, a conifer. Although you can forgive anyone for thinking it, because it really does look like one. And it's often used in the construction industry, particularly in these coastal areas where you can't grow much. And the other tree that's mostly found in these areas, of course, is mangrove, which was traditionally used in construction. It has been threatened through the demand for its use as a construction material. So you really would rather be using something like this so that you can grow quite quickly and then you can use. One of the nicest uses I've seen over and over again, by the way, you can see I'm really sweating here because it's hot as Hades here in Lamu. Beautiful, beautiful place, by the way. If you ever want to go somewhere really exotic and unusual on holiday, I highly recommend it. One thing that's a beautiful use of this is as a roofing shingle. And it's very common around here to see roofs made of that. You can hear a passing boat go by. I'll give you a shot of what that looks like just now. I'm standing right on the waterfront. We must be 5 meters away from the sea, this line of trees behind me. And the soil here is definitely saline. The water that comes out of the tap here is saline. But these trees are surviving amazingly, amazingly. Casuarina, the name comes from a Malay word for the cassowary bird. Cassowary bird found in Southeast Asia, big feathers, well known, very kind of charismatic bird. And these, we have a strong similarity to that. And so that's the first part of the name. And then equisetum again, implying what it looks like. So equus, horse, obviously in Latin, and equisetum means horse tail. And you can see exactly where that comes from. Next time you're on the beach and you look up and you wonder what on earth these pine-like trees are doing there, you will now be able to turn and impress your friends and say, actually, that's a Casuarina equisetum, so named because it looks like a horse tail, planted here because of its resistance to saline soils and its ability to stabilize soil. Your friends will not in any way be impressed, and they will probably walk away and abandon you right there and then, but you will feel, my friend, so much better. I'm Gus, the African plant hunter, melting here in Lamu. It's been fantastic talking to you guys. I will catch you again really soon. If we haven't met before, this is what I do. I've got a whole channel, africanplanthunter.com, with lots of material about indigenous plants of Africa. Catch you later. Bye.